power two. I pulled out the USB-C cable, which I was lucky enough to get, because at the time that I ordered it, it was actually listed as a USB 3 on the front. Shouldn't be too hard to put that back in, but I'll leave it out for now. Although it's actually also, well, the power cable is actually cable tied to it, but they're not part of the same assembly, so should be all right. Just a CPU cable left. Might actually look what the suggested routing is for the CPU cable, because I got the other one wrong. Actually, they don't seem to suggest it, but it's a pretty straight run, so I guess I can't screw it up too bad. So this is actually the first, the most tight thing so far. This is the most awkward bit. The rest of it's been very straightforward. All right, that's done. It's plugged into the power supply. Right, that seems to be all built together. The card is a GTX 1080 non-TI, and it fits pretty well. There's a little bit of space there. I didn't have to force it. I'll just try the putting the panels back on. So the panels have these little standoffs. They just clip into the case. And that is the wrong side. Seems all right. So as I screw these in, I can tell that these are very soft. So if I force them at all, I'm gonna get some silver color right on top of my case. So I'm not sure if that'll show up, but you can already see that even though I'm being quite careful and gentle, the screws are getting the paint stripped. There we go, you can see just a little hint of silver. So the metal there might be a little too soft. And I'm using this little DeWalt bit, which actually fits really well. So, and it's not stripped at all. So, that's not the fault of the bit. So, also, I just noticed that on this edge here, it doesn't line up properly. And if you look at the front, it lines up properly on the leading edge. And then as you go along, it kind of gets a little bit out of tilt. There is play in the side panel. I can push it up to make it line up a little bit, but it's not going to help that much. Doesn't seem to bother, like I don't think it'll bother me, but other people might want it to be a little bit more precise, so watch out for that. Oh, and it's possible that I did something wrong, so that's something to consider as well. So this is mostly it, and it's a little bit of a Frankenstein on this side. So I reckon I shouldn't think about it at all and just try to power on and see what happens. Yeah, I'll just get these last screws in. This is the power button cable. It has a little connector for the power button and just a single motherboard header. Don't remember where my power button is, so this might be interesting. So this is definitely a problem I've never had. Trying to figure out where my power is. I should have definitely plugged this cable in before I put everything else together. But I can I think I can just force it with a, well, just push it in with a chopstick. Yep, that went in easily enough. Just tuck it away. I guess I just need to see if it boots. Right, hopefully there's no smoke. Right, maybe I did not actually get the power button. I thought I did. Might actually have to grab my motherboard manual, which is a painful thing to say. Okay, so it actually my motherboard actually has this little loom that plugs into the motherboard and then has the labeled connectors broken out, so that's why I could not find it. Actually, so the power switch is yellow and orange, yellow and orange. Go to these ones. My trusty chopstick. Nope, that's not it. Boom, that worked. Maybe the monitor will turn on as well. That'll be nice. There we go. Huh. So I'll it blue screened. I'll let it do its thing. It's collecting error info. So that monitor was an old one given to me from work, so I'd probably ignore that little noise that came out before, but seems to be working well enough. I'll probably leave it for the time being. The resolution seems to be too low. Which is odd because I was using this PC with this monitor earlier. But I'll figure that out later. Thank you.